Assalamu alaikum student, in today class we will continue our sequence chapter of IBHL core mathematics. We will continue our chapter of IB mathematics sequence chapter, second chapter. Now there is question, find the k given the consecutive arithmetic terms. Now 32k3, now this is given. He is saying in this arithmetic sequence find the value of k. Sequence is given 32k3 and he is saying find the value of k. Sequence is given, exercise 2C. Question 5. Sequence given 32K and 3. Now he is saying find the value of K. Find the value of K. Or given it is arithmetic sequence. Arithmetic sequence given. And he's saying find the value of k. I'm checking question again. 32K3. This is the sequence. 32K3. Okay, now it is correct. Now how we find the value of k if this is arithmetic? In this situation we apply the rule of arithmetic. What is an arithmetic sequence? Second term minus third term, k minus 32, it's mean u2 minus u1 always equal to u3 minus u2, because these all are equal to common difference. u2 minus u1 mean k minus 32 equal to u3 minus u2 mean 3 minus k. Now this is the way by which we can calculate k easily. Transfer the k at same side, k plus k, and transfer the number at same side, 32 from here to second side, 3 plus 32. Now we get here 32 plus 3 mean 35. Now k plus k mean 2k, it's mean k equal to k equal to 35/2. Now this is the value of k. Clear? When we divide it we can find in decimal. 2 1s are 2, 1 remainder 17, 2 7s are 14.5. 17.5 is k coming. Okay student? Now by this way in a sequence, arithmetic sequence, we can calculate the missing value. Okay, check the other question. Now in this question you can also calculate k easily. You subtract 2k plus 1 from 2k minus 1 equal to 13 minus 2k, then you get easily. Now I am solving the c part. It is a difficult little difficult than a part. Now I am writing the c part. 5k square minus 8. This is a question. C part 5k square minus 8. Now this is a question. Now it's saying find the k. Now same rule is applied for arithmetic sequence. We apply the D rule, common difference rule. How we find the difference of the term? according to formula u2 minus u1 equal to u3 minus u2. There is 5 u1 k u2 and k square minus 8 is u3. Now put all these value in this formula. K minus 5 k square minus 8 minus k. Okay, at the place of u3 put k square minus 8, at the place of u2 put k, at the place of u2 put k, and at the place of u1 put 5. Now we can calculate easily the sequence value of k. Transfer all values at same side, because it may be when we transfer all the values we get quadratic equation. Okay, now check k square minus 8 minus k at one side, transfer these two k minus 5 second side, minus k plus 5 we get here equal to 0. Now solve it. K square minus k mean minus 2k, minus 8 and plus 3 mean minus 3. Now this becomes quadratic equation. If we are finding here the quadratic equation, if we are finding the k here from quadratic equation, we factorize it with the help of 3, and there is 1 given in last term and one, first term, we can get easily 2. We factorize it, we break the midterm. Minus 3k plus 2k, okay. Minus 3k plus 1k. 3 and 1 are the factors. If we are finding the factor, we involve the last term and the first term. First term there is, in first term there is constant 1 and there is 3. With the help of these two we can break the midterm. 3 minus 1 we get minus 2. Okay, I keep here minus 3 because there is minus 2. Minus 3k, and there from 1 we I take 1 and plus k I add in it. Now k square minus 3k plus 2, I break this minus 2 according to 3 and 1. Okay, if I want to find here 2 and given factors are 3 and 1, the easy way, you minus 1 from 3 you get 2. Okay, now minus 3 remains same address. This is the way of factorization. Okay, if factorization is not clear, you tell me, I will make for video for you for factorization. Okay, if factorization is not clear. Now I am taking common here from k. Now what remains here? K minus 3. Now take 1 common here. Now what remain here? K minus 3 equal to 0. Take common k minus 3 from this. Now what is coming here? K plus 1 equal to 0. Now k minus 3 equal to 0 mean k equal to 3, and k plus 1 equal to 0 mean k equal to minus 1. It's been two values are coming here for sequence. You put these value in sequence and check sequence on which value sequence is same. 5k k square minus 8. This is the sequence. 5k k square minus 8. Put these values respectively. Firstly 3 put in it, then check sequence coming same or not. I am putting here at the place of k value of 3. Okay, now I put here at the place of k 3. Firstly 5 3, then 3 square mean 9 minus 8. Now you get sequence 5 3 and 1. Now check d is same or not same. Subtract second term from first term, 3 minus 5, it's been 2 is coming. Now subtract third term from second term, 1 minus 3, it's mean minus 1 is minus 2 is coming here. On firstly we also get minus 2, and secondly we also get minus, it's mean common difference is same. Now k is exactly correct for this sequence when k equal to 3. Now on 1 you can minus 1, second value is minus 1, you can also check the sequence is coming as arithmetic progression or arithmetic sequence or not. First term is 5, second term is k, and third term is k square minus 8. Now put 1 at the place of k. Now you get here 5, 1, 1 square 1, 8 minus 1 means minus 7. Now there is minus 1, na? Put 8 minus 1. Minus 1, minus 1 square mean 1 and minus 7 coming. 5 minus 1 and minus 4. Now check D is coming same or not. Here I put at the place of K minus 1 and this sequence is coming. 5 minus 1 minus 7. Now check D is same or not same. Second term minus first term. Minus 1 minus 5 minus 6 is coming. Secondly D, third term minus first term. Minus 7 minus minus 1. It's mean minus 7 plus 1. It's been minus 6, 6 coming. It's been D is same. Both situation when k equal to 3 or k equal to minus 1, arithmetic sequence progressions is coming. It's mean these are the correct value of k, k equal to 3 or k equal to minus 1. Okay. Okay, student, now I am solving next question. Question 6. Question 6. Find the general term un for an arithmetic sequence. U7 and U13 there is given. U7 and U13. Find the general term for this sequence. U7. Now question. Question 5, okay, sorry, previous one. Question 6. U7, 41, U13, 77. There is given in question 6. U7, 31. And there is given U13, 77. These two sequences are given. U7, 41. Or U13, 77. This sequence is given. What happened with the board? Board is hanged. I'm opening again the port. IB Mathematics question 6 from 2C exercise. board was hang, therefore I open the board again, and now I am solving again the question 6. In front of you, check the solution. This was the 5 question we have solved here. Now I am solving the question 7. Question 6, sorry. There is given you 741. Sorry, in this question it is given 41. U7 is 41. And nextly given in question, U13 is 77. Now he's saying find the general term UN, and we know that UN is equal to U1 plus N minus 1 and D. Okay, and in general term we are not putting UN. Okay, if there is term given just like 7, 5, 3, then we put N, but if N is not given, we only put these values U1, D, and we can get the general term. If two terms are given in this type of question, how we find the U1, first term, and D? When we get these term, then we get easily the general term. Okay, I am solving U7. If there is given U7 is 41. Now how we solve this U7 41? You put in general term formula U7. U7, U1 is not given, plus at the place where input 7. 7 minus 1 and D is not given. Now U7, we know that it is equal to 41 according to question. Now U1 plus 7 minus 1 means 6D. Now this is the first equation coming here with the help of U7 term. Now I am finding the U13 equation. U13 mean U1 is not given, plus at the place of N 13 is coming, 13 minus 1, D is not given. These are we finding U1 and D. U1, 13 minus 1 mean 12, D. Now U13 is given as, in my opinion, 77. It is given in question as 77. U13 is 77. U7, 41. I put here 41 and get first equation. Now I am finding second equation. Now what we will do after finding these? Now this is our second equation. Now write this equation vertically. 41 U1 plus 60. U1 plus 41 equal to U1 plus 60. If we get with the help of these two equation, now we can find U1 and D easily by solving these equation simultaneously. Okay, if there is problem in simultaneous equation, you tell me in comment sign. I will solve some simultaneous equation in next different video for you. Okay, if we are finding U1 and D, we solve it simultaneously. How we solve simultaneously? These U1 and U1 are same. We subtract the two equations. If these are same with same sign, we subtract the whole equation. Now these are cancelled. You subtract 41 minus 77. It's mean minus, because 77 is greater with minus sign. Now subtract 1 from 7, it's mean 6 coming. Now subtract 4 from 7, it's mean 36. Minus 36 is coming. Difference of these two, minus 77 and 41, is minus 36. U1 both are cancelled because both having different sign and both are same. Now here subtract when you 6D from 12D, you get minus 60. Now minus minus cancel both side, D is equal to now 36 upon 6. This become divide, और डिवाइड द 36, तो 6 6 द 36 इज कमिंग, इट्स मीन योर डी वैल्यू इज कमिंग हेयर 6. ओके नाउ डी एस 6. नाउ वी आर फाइंडिंग द यू वन. नाउ हाउ वी फाइंड इन साइमल्टेनियस इक्वेशन यू वन, यू पुट दिस वैल्यू ऑफ डी इन एनी वन इक्वेशन अबव इक्वेशन 1 or 2. आई एम पुटिंग इन 1 41, यू वन वी आर फाइंडिंग हेयर प्लस 6 एंड डी इज 6. Okay, now put the value of D in it and you can get easily. Now this is the simultaneous equation solution. Now 41 equal to U1 plus 6 6, the 36. Now subtract 41 minus 36. Now you get U1 here. When you subtract 36 from 41, you get here 5. It's been U1 is coming 5. Now it is completed. When two terms given, just like U7 and U15 given, and we firstly form two equation, different equations of 7 term of or 13 term, with the help of these two equation we can find easily the U1 and D. Now we are finding the general term. When we know about the values of U1 and D, now we can get easily the general term. Apply the formula of general term. What is the formula of general term? We know that in previous questions we have solved this. UN is equal to U1 plus N minus 1. This is the general term formula. Now in this term formula you put the value of U1 and D. What is U1 coming? 5 plus, and remains same in general term, minus 1, and at the place of D you put value of D. What is coming D? What was the value of D? Now I'm checking, in my opinion it was 6. Yes, D was 6. D was 6. Now put in it in general term formula. Five plus, the multiply it, 6n minus 6. Now 6n same. When you subtract 5 and minus 6, then get minus 1. General term is coming un 6n minus 1. Okay student, now let us finish. Subscribe my channel, get more video related to IB mathematics. Inshallah, in different videos I will also make the video related to it, Excel mathematics, O-level mathematics, A-level mathematics, or BSc mathematics. Subscribe my channel, get more video. If you want to get any video of your topic, you can comment on my comment sign and get video related to this topic. Assalamu alaikum.